What's up, you guys? It's me, Luke, and welcome back to another vlog. I am resurrecting Loki Luke, the vlog channel that I have been neglecting. I have not posted on this channel in like a year. I've been really focused on my main channel since, you know, coming back to YouTube after taking a break. So unfortunately, I haven't been posting that much on here. I have been vlogging a lot on my Patreon. If you don't know, I have a Patreon. So I post a ton of different bonus content on there, and I'll link it down below. But this vlog is a very special vlog that I wanted to share with everyone. For anyone who watches and supports me, whether it's on YouTube or on Patreon, I wanted anyone and everyone to be able to watch this video, because even though I don't post that much content about Taylor on my YouTube channel, because I don't really make videos about music, I do post a lot about her on Twitter, and I obviously make references to her in some of my videos. And I am a huge bona fide Swiftie, and going to the ERAS tour has been a dream of mine since it was first announced, or just seeing Taylor live in general. And I just wanted to share that with you guys, because if it wasn't for, you know, the support of you guys and for supporting my videos on YouTube and Patreon, I wouldn't have been able to do this. And this video is, a lot of it is, you know, the concert at the ERAS tour. I went to Melbourne night one, and I will do a big debrief at the end of this vlog where I get to actually talk about my concrete thoughts, because I was in a lot of shock after the concert and I needed time to process my thoughts. As I'm filming this, it's been a little over a week. I'm back home in Brisbane, as you can tell by the beads of sweat running down my face. Already missing the weather in Melbourne. I just wanted to give a little intro to this video because I wanted to let you know what you're in for. First of all, I did vlog some of my time in Melbourne, which will be included in this vlog. I didn't want to separate it because for me, it was all kind of interlinked. While I was in Melbourne, even though I was sightseeing and all that kind of stuff, I have been to Melbourne once before. So really the purpose of this trip was the ERAS tour, and my younger sister who went with me hadn't been to Melbourne. So I was showing her a lot of the places I'd already been to. So I did kind of put a little Taylor twist on this video. And anytime I play music over any sort of montage footage, it's a Taylor song that I think fits the vibe of what I was feeling or what is being shown. So I hope you enjoyed that too. I don't care about making money off of this video. I just want it to be a big fun Taylor fest. So UMG, you can take the money from this video if there is any. But yeah, I don't know. This video was just a lot of fun for me to make and edit. And I had severe concert amnesia after the concert where I just felt like I didn't remember any of it. So going back and watching the footage and editing this really helped me rejog my memory. And when it comes to the footage from the concert portion of this video, it's obviously not the best. Like, I didn't have a full on setup, but I do think I did pretty well. What I did is I had three different ways of getting footage for this vlog. I had my G7X camera, which I would use to film me and my sister's faces, our reactions. And then I would have my cell phone, which I would use to film Taylor because the zoom's better on my phone for some reason. However, because I didn't want to be watching the concert through a screen, I was kind of filming like this and then watching the concert with my eyes. So some of the footage is a little shaky. I did my best to, you know, finesse it. And then my younger sister was also filming some stuff on her phone. So I have three different ways of showing some footage. There's definitely some sets or some eras that I filmed a lot more than others. I would say like the beginning of the concert, I didn't really film that much because I was just really soaking it in. In fact, during her intro with Miss Americana, I did get some footage from someone else who went to Melbourne night one, just so that I could use that to show you guys what I was seeing. But the rest of the footage is all mine, my sister's. I think that's enough gabbing for me. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope this is the start of me posting on this channel more. Vlogging on Patreon has given me a bit more confidence to do that. But at the same time, my life's not that interesting. But this week, however, was a highlight of my life. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I will catch you at the end of it for my debrief of my thoughts of the concert. I'm just so excited for you guys to watch it. Also, you're not ready for the clubbing scene. Me and my sister went clubbing. It was nuts. So look forward to that. Chat to you soon.
Look what you made me look what you just made me do.
Look what you just made me do.
Do I look like a truck driver? Oh.
We have arrived in Melbourne after a delayed flight and a really long bus. It is 11:15 p.m. They are an hour ahead of us, so it's technically 10 p.m. from Brisbane.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Vibes!
And I'm severely dehydrated. Hello, where is the light? Good morning, you guys. I look like a fucking egg. We made it to Melbourne. Not sure if you can see the view. It's a little blown out, but this is the view from the hotel room. It's gonna be a bit noisy. Ugh. Oh, it's been a while since I have even heard from- There's my sestra.
Hey!
Isabella.
Yeah, I obviously haven't done like a proper intro, but we're here in Melbourne for Taylor Swift's ERAS tour. We're going to the opening night of the Australian leg of the tour. And then just spending a couple days here because I've only been to Melbourne once and I love it and Bella's never been before. So gonna do some exploring. Yesterday was quite rough. The plane was delayed. There were crying babies on the plane. There was sneezing people. There was an old man sitting next to me who kept convulsing. We probably got a little too tipsy. And then the airport in Melbourne is really far away from the city, so we had to get a bus. So that took ages, and then we had to get an Uber here, and the Uber driver smelled like poop.
Yo, what the fuck, hey?
Maybe he's wearing like a diaper so he doesn't have to take breaks.
Come on now.
And then, I had a terrible sleep last night, but you live and you live. So we're here, gonna get a coffee and breakfast, get a couple groceries, cause to save a bit of money, considering how expensive everything was.
Jesus.
Yeah, with like, the inflation because of so many people coming here this weekend. We got a hotel room that has a little kitchenette. So we've got a fridge in there, a microwave, a stovetop, kettle, toaster, knives, that kit and caboodle. This is kind of like a little dining area. The bed, me and Bella are sharing a bed like when we were kids, sleepover vibes. Just like a little table, which would have been nice if it had a mirror. Kind of weird how the TV's there and the bed's there, but I digress. And then the little bathroom. So it kind of has everything that you need. Watch us go round and round each time. Today is the day of the concert. Doesn't really feel real yet.
No.
We've just got breakfast and coffee this morning, and now we are trying to go to a grocery store, and I'm getting lost, so.
Yeah, it's a real struggle to.
Well, last time I was here, I was in like the middle of the CBD, and now we're like in a different area.
Everything's really spread out.
Yeah, but it's cute. I'm excited for Bella to see like the CBD. I don't think we're gonna see it today. And the weather's nice.
So far, that's like my favorite thing, I'd say, is the weather.
And the lack of humidity.
The lack of humidity, and also like how it's not very busy. But to be fair, that's because we're not in the city, but just like it's a nice area. Little bird bob!
Making my way downtown, walking fast in my demon town, I'm homebound.
I
was wanting to know, I'd meet you where the spirit meets the bones. Faith forgotten land. In from the snow, your touch brought forth an incandescent glow.
Alrighty guys, we are ready for the ERAS tour. Oh my god, it's like 5 p.m. People have been there since like 4. I feel like I'm late even though I'm not. Sabrina only comes on at 6:20 and it takes 30 minutes to get there, so we should be getting there just up to 5:30, but let's do an OOTD, an OOT, as I was about to say Stefan, Paul Wesley says. So let's do Bella first.
Still finishing off the makeup.
Well, let's do full body and then we'll do details. Yeah. This is Bella's look. She has got an Evermore Reputation hybrid. How are the boots feeling?
Good, actually. Super comfy.
So yeah, these are the shoes.
They're pretty thick heel.
Nine West, I think.
Yes.
Sparkly tights from Boohoo. This Evermore, what do you call this?
Plaid
print is actually from Kmart, Slay. She's got this Reputation necklace getup. She's got the name and the snake. And then some like sort of fearless guitars for Reputation folk. No, I keep messing up. Reputation Evermore hybrid makeup look.
And then I'm gonna wear like a pretty nude look.
Oh, let's see the nails.
Oh, and the nails. Got some silver jewelry.
Nails are super cute. Bracelets.
Hey, Steven, Evermore. And of course, Slay. Because that's what we are.
I actually plaited her hair. Wait, let's get it with the light. But I think it looks super cute. This plaid, very Evermore. Very, like, imagine putting Evermore and Evermore and Reputation together. Like,
bad bitch.
How many people are doing that?
She's a sad but bad bitch.
Okay, and then you do me. Can you guess what era I'm representing? Level extremely hard. So I'm doing a red and folklore hybrid. So obviously we've got this full getup kind of going on here. So we've got just some white Converse with these love heart socks from the
so
women's
cute.
Section of Kmart. These shorts are from TK Maxx, discounted, very stretchy.
Yes!
Belt is Kmart giving cowboy. We on a budget.
Can I just say
that? I've got some friendship bracelets that I'm going to give away attached to the belt because like, they're very limited about how you can bring them in.
Yeah.
And then the shirt is actually also from Kmart. Originally had
Kmart came through!
I know, originally had a shirt coming from Etsy, but the seller was just awful. So yeah, it's a singlet, so very breathable. I can take this jacket. I've got Roland in my bag, so. And then this jacket is from Boohoo, the
so
women's section.
So freaking cute.
Yeah, it's so sparkly.
Like, can we take a moment?
And it is very uncomfortable.
Yes, that's the one thing is, I'm very surprised they didn't do any lining underneath. Yeah. Do you think they
would?
And then
these are the nails and the rings. Obviously some red rings.
Oh wait, it's just gotta focus, sorry.
some red rings.
There we go. Gorgeous. And red nails.
Let's and then I've got some bracelets. We've got All Too Well, This Is Me Trying, Right Where You Left Me, Would Have, Could Have, Should Have, I Almost Do, Tolerate It, and Treacherous. And then the look, we've got a, because by the way, this is a red folklore hybrid. This is giving folklore, I feel.
Mm, right? Yeah.
And then this is some folklore jewelry. So, we've, oh, I do have an Evermore necklace because I do stan Evermore. I just couldn't fit it into the fit. But we've got the Love You to the Moon and to Saturn necklace from Seven on Folklore. We've got the Mirable earrings from Mirable. And then just these like shiny little clips, which I thought just add to the vibe.
And a very natural makeup look.
Well, I get really sweaty, and so
Luke has also very sensitive eyes.
Yeah, I have sensitive eyes, so I just wanted to keep it really simple. And then the hair is just kind of
whatever. So pretty.
Yeah, I'm a little bit nervous because, like, even though you think it's Swifties and it's going to be a safe space, there's still going to be, like,
some judgment.
Yeah, there's going to be some judgy moms.
Some competition.
There's going to be some homophobic boyfriends. There's, you know what I mean? So it's a bit, but I'm hoping for the most part everyone will be nice because we're just all there to... We're all there to have fun.
I tell you, that better be nice, because, you know, I'll be there and I'll be doing something, if at all. I will.
I don't even know what the fuck you're saying. Work, bitch. You better work, bitch. Yeah. So, yeah, I feel like we look super cute together. Rep, Evermore, Folklore, and Red, which are actually four of my top five albums.
Yeah.
So, the other one is kind of a toss-up between Speak Now
and
Midnights for me.
Yes, I would say mine would be Fearless, Red. See, it's a toss-up between Rep and 1989. I really struggle with those two because I like both them
good.
So much. But,
yeah, Red's number one for me. Everyone's playing second
of
best.
Of course!
Yeah, we look really good. So, we're going to go now. Hopefully, we're not going to be late. We will see you there. Bye!
Bye!
Thank you for having us here.
Yeah!
The shirts are so hot. What the hell?
meet with Sabrina Carpenter.
Yes, Sabrina! Yes, Sabrina!
We're about to go on a little adventure together, and that adventure is about to span 18 years of music. And we're going to do this one era at a time.
How does yeah!
songs that I may have written about my feelings or my life, or maybe an imaginary story I came up with in my mind, and maybe that's what you think about when you hear these songs.
Just don't know the answer. Someone's on it. It's like every night I do two different songs, ones that are not part of the set list, and it's really fun. It's just kind of like, you know, I get to kind of have this moment of like every single day picking those songs for that particular crowd and like hoping that it makes you happy. Tonight, I'm gonna do one of my favorite ones. It was really a lifeline for me. Just the things I was going through, the things I was writing about, it was like, it kind of reminded me of why songwriting is something that like actually gets me through my life. And I've never had an album where I needed songwriting more than I needed it on Torture Poets. And I wanted to show you something tonight because it's
to be the bravest soldier.
Look in the mirror, please. Just look in the mirror and reevaluate what's going on here. I have a lot of questions.
I would think I was on crack. I would think I was on that crack.
Hey, you guys. So it is the next day. P.E.T. post ERAS tour. Oh my god. It is now like 3 p.m. We got home last night at 1, I want to say. Right?
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, it was really difficult to leave the stadium because obviously, you know, there was 96,000 people there. All the trams were full. Like, I got really confused with which direction we were supposed to be going, and we were trying to get Ubers. They weren't, like, answering. But, like, that is all besides the point. Like, the end of the night is like, but, like, the actual concert was insane. I feel like I need a couple more days to, like, process my thoughts. You know, I got some merch. I got the shirt. I also got the coveted blue sweater, so I'll show you that another time. But, yeah, just as, like, a general afterthought of, like, how I feel is I feel like it wasn't real. I feel like she was a hologram. I feel like it was a simulation, and mentally not doing okay with the surprise songs we got. Red. I was wearing a red themed fit. I was actually one of the few people. I didn't see many people or anyone that I can recall in a red fit. So that was really fun for me. And then also You're Losing Me, which is iconic. She also announced another edition of the Dead Poets Department, and her speeches were amazing. They felt so different and unique based on the ones I'd seen in live streams, and it was so fun. I will say that I'm a little disappointed that I could not really see Sabrina very well because, and this has nothing to do with the concert, it's just like weather. When Sabrina came on, the sun was setting, so it was like blaring in our eyes, and like I was trying to do this, but I could just kind of barely see her. I did see her here and there, but we were in the lower bowl head on, which would normally be a great seat, and it was a great seat, but because the MCG is so big and the stage didn't even take up half of the floor, Taylor was kind of like a little bit of an ant, but you know, I could still see her like moving around on the stage. We did watch the screens a lot, but overall it was amazing. Like, actually being there was next level. I was in a lot of shock. Bella was crying and screaming and convulsing. But yeah, I feel like I need time to really sit with that because it's very fresh in my mind. But now, you know, that was kind of part one of our trip, was getting here, getting ready, the ERAS tour. And it is kind of weird, I was saying when we were going for a coffee this morning about how I feel like the highlight of the trip is already over. Like, it was at the beginning and now it's done, but I've had to recalibrate it in my mind and be like, okay, that was part one of the Melbourne trip, was the ERAS tour. Now part two is actually experiencing the city.
Yeah,
because I've only been here once. Bella's never been here before, and I feel like even though we're here, it doesn't feel like we're here because we haven't even gone to the city yet, because we're staying a little bit outside of the city. As you can see, I didn't even realize you can actually see the ocean.
Yeah,
so there's like a river there and then the ocean.
It's a pretty good view, actually.
Yeah, we've got two views, you know, more of like the city and stuff. The city's like, I believe, that way. And look, my thingy's still flashing. I'm wearing it today. Is that like obnoxious, do you think?
No.
You don't think it is?
Nope. I think it's cute.
It feels kind of weird. I'm like wondering, do you think there's like radiation in it? Because it's like, how is it still flashing? Actually, I'm not going to wear it. It's freaking me out. But yeah, so we will take you along for the journey of what we get up to today. We're not really sure because it is so late. We're pretty hungry. All we've had is two boiled eggs. So we're like either gonna get a late lunch or an early dinner. Thinking of going to the Eureka Sky Deck, which is the tallest building in the Southern Hemisphere. I've been there before, Val hasn't, so I would be happy to do it again. And then also considering going clubbing tonight, but I still feel like shit from last night because we did have some dranky doos. But I'm also wondering if it's because I haven't eaten enough. So
yeah, I think it's bad.
Yeah, but that's pretty much the update. I'm loving my new shirt. Bella also got one. She's not wearing it today, but she got one. She was wearing it this morning. Super cute. And oh my god, my friendship bracelets. Let me just show them how many friendship bracelets I got. Please ignore that fork. Oh, I just dropped one. But yeah, lots of friendship bracelets. It was so fun trading with people. And I honestly have so much to say about the experience in general, but we're hungry as fuck, so I'll tell you later. Peace.
Drunk on something stronger than the drinks in the bar. I rent a place on Cornelius Street. I sit casually in the car. We were a fresh page on the desk, filling in the blanks as we go. As if the street lights pointed in an arrowhead leading us home.
Too late.
Is that an issue?
That's a loss of income. Your bills have been affected.
down.
Yes! Yes!
Hey, one, two.
Alrighty guys, you probably gathered it from that previous clip, and me and Bella are going clubbing. Please don't tell me you're barfing. Nah, just swiping that thing. So this is the fit. Shirts, vintage, thrifted, don't remember where. Jeans are Calvin Klein, vegan Doc Martens, do not recommend, get the legits. Wearing some of my ERAS tool jewelry because I'm nostalgic. I've been trying to get tickets to Night 3 and been failing, but that's the look. How do you feel?
Vibes.
Looking super cute. Vibe. She's got like a little pleather skirt. Little pleather skirt. The beats from last night. Hopefully they do better than...
This is from South Africa. It's from a...
True Words.
True Words! Oh my god, yes! No, exactly. It's from True Words. You're so right.
Well, yes. I want to film in the elevator because I feel like it's got good vibes, you know? I'm gonna bring these other bitches down. Set soon-ish.
My love was as cruel as the cities I lived in. Everyone looked worse in the light. There are so many lines that I've crossed unforgiven. I'll tell you the truth, but never goodbye.
Hello you guys. Oh my god, this lighting is actually really kind of a vibe. The sun is setting. It is really crazy. I don't know if it's called daylight savings time or whatever it is, but here in Melbourne the sun sets so much later. Like, let me check what time it is. It's 8 p.m. and that's what it looks like outside. Crazy. In Brisbane the sun sets in summer at like 7, I want to say. So that's really fun, but it does make it hard to like tell what time it is. So I just wanted to chat with you because I feel like I haven't. I've just been like filming stuff, which I think is kind of good because it's better to show than tell. As you can tell, my voice is kind of fried. I did think that it would have been worse after the concert, but I think I was on the verge, and then going out clubbing last night, it's just really rough. Like, it hurts to talk, which is kind of why I haven't been talking that much. And you know me, I love to talk. Yeah, so me and my sister last night, we went clubbing. And clubbing here, like, the clubs stay up so much later. Like, in Brisbane, they have, like, these laws where the clubs have to close at 3. Whereas here, they're, like, open till 7, 11 a.m., whatever. So we went out at midnight last night and then got back to the hotel at, like, 5 a.m. And we met these amazing, hilarious American girls on the tram, and we spent the whole night with them. We went to a club called Storyville, and then another club called Levels, and it was super fun. But I think that's what did it for my voice. My throat hurts, my voice hurts. So today I wanted to go to St. Kilda because it was my favorite place that I went to last time I came to Melbourne. And I wanted to show Bella, but they had this huge festival. It's like the St. Kilda Festival happens once a year, and it just happened to be the day that we chose to go. So it was a lot busier than usual, but it was still really cool to see the people, look at the markets, and all that kind of stuff. We went to the park that I really like there, but we're gonna go back to St. Kilda another day because I was getting a really bad stomach ache. I was not feeling well. I had to come back and lie down. I think I've caught something. Doesn't feel like COVID, it just feels like the flu, or maybe I'm just run down from lack of sleep because we only got like probably 4.5 hours of sleep last night. But yeah, we're having a very chill night tonight. It's Sunday. We wanted to go to one of those outdoor cinemas, but unfortunately, because of the daylight, I didn't realize how late it was and we missed it. It started at like 7. So now we're going to watch a movie at like just a regular cinema, but like a really bougie one. Cinema tickets here are very expensive. In Brisbane, I usually spend like $9. Here it was like $20. And we're watching a movie called All the Lovely Strangers. Yeah, something like that. So yeah, we're just going to go watch a movie. And then tomorrow, we're here for 2 more days after today. So the next 2 days are really going to be about just exploring. Our budget is kind of stretched thin. We've already pre-booked doing the Eureka Sky Tower, which is like the tallest building in the Southern Hemisphere. You can see all over Melbourne, super fast elevator. I'll take you along for that. But the next 2 days are really just gonna be about exploring. I'm gonna go back to St. Kilda. I'm gonna take Bella to Fitzroy and then maybe try to see the city again. But yeah, I'll take you guys along for it. I feel like when I get home is when I'm gonna have to like have a proper sit down and talk to you about the ERAS tour, because I'm really trying to fathom a lot of what's been going on. I've actually been trying all of like a lot throughout today and yesterday to try to get another ticket so I could go to another night on Marketplace. Unfortunately, I didn't, but that's okay because I already went once and it was amazing, so I'm not that upset. But yeah, I think we'll just kind of enjoy the rest of the trip, and when I get back home is when I'll really have like a proper debrief with you guys, because a lot needs to be said. But unfortunately, as you can probably tell, my voice hurts and it sounds like shit. So I'll probably chat to you later. Building in the Southern Hemisphere on the fastest elevator.
Easy.
Alrighty guys, it's mine and Bella's last night in Melbourne.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, she just spilled her water. and it is our first time going to dinner at a restaurant. Last night we went to, no, this morning we went to breakfast, I showed you that. And then we went to lunch over in St. Kilda the other day. We're going to St. Kilda for dinner tonight because it was super busy when we went there the other day, big festival, so I wanna go there again. We're trying to catch the sunset, it's going down pretty soon, so hopefully we get to see it. And then tomorrow our checkout is at 10, so we're gonna wake up and deal with our bags. And then we're just gonna spend most of the day probably in Fitzroy is like the main place, maybe a little bit in the city, and then come back and then make our way to the airport. And honestly, normally when I like a trip finishes up, I'm like sad to go home. Well, then now that I think about that, it's really only happened once last time I came to Melbourne, but this time I feel like we've really got to do a lot. It's been amazing. And this, you know, this time around I have something to go back to. I really miss my kitties. But yeah, really exciting to just have a nice last night. And it doesn't even feel like, oh my God, the trip's over, because we still have a whole day tomorrow.
Yeah.
So we're still gonna see some stuff tomorrow. And today was super cute, like going to the sky deck. We had a cocktail and a bottle of wine and chatted, and it was really fun. So I'm excited for tonight.
fast forward to 300 takeout copies later. I see your profile and your smile on unsuspecting waiters. You dream of my mouth before it called you a lying traitor. You search in every maiden's bed for something greater, baby. Was it over?
Hey y'all, so it is our last day in Melbourne and our checkout at the hotel was at 10 a.m. but our flight doesn't leave till 10 p.m. so we've left our bags over there and we have just been wandering around, walking around, exploring. We were at the city a little bit this morning, but we've done a lot in the city. So we've been in Fitzroy for half the day. It's almost 2 p.m. we went to Chinatown, we've seen the St. Patrick's Cathedral, we're now walking in Fitzroy Park. And then after this, we're gonna go to St. Kilda again. And then we're going home. And it's just really nice to soak everything in. And I feel like the amount of time that we came here was perfect, don't you?
Yes, just the right amount.
Yeah, like today's the day where I'm like, ooh, I am ready to go home.
Oh my god, which length
I mean, yeah. Oh my god, this is reminding me of like in one of my South Africa.
Oh,
in my South Africa vlog when you and I were pretending to be Diego and
Dora
and we were trying to like find where we were going.
That was so fun.
That was like weird foreshadowing because then I was in the Dora movie the next year.
Oh my god, yeah.
Or was it the maybe it was the year before that actually. It was like before we went. I love Melbourne. It's my favorite city I've been to in Australia. It's my second time here and it's been really nice. It's been really cool to share it with Bella. It was her first time.
Yes.
What are your thoughts?
I've been probably wanting to come here like, you know, since
you knew about it.
Yeah, since I knew about it. Because like, yeah, people talk about Sydney, but I don't know, I think I was just more excited for Melbourne, I guess, because it's so different from like the whole Australian.
Yeah, it's got a bit of a uniqueness about it.
Like, it's very unique and very diverse in its culture. And
I mean, I've only been to Sydney once and it was sort of like a little family trip, so I do want to go again so I can experience it.
Yeah, no, I definitely do want to go to Sydney, but I'm very much glad that I came here first.
Yeah,
I will be coming again. I will.
Yes, for
sure. There's still so much to explore.
Down the block there's an antique shop and something in my head said stop, so I walked in.
Hi, Melbourne. You've been real.
You know when it's time to go.
Alrighty guys, so that is the end of my Melbourne vlog, my ERAS tour experience. I felt really rushed in the intro because I knew people probably just wanted to watch the vlog, but now is the moment where we can really talk about it. I think I need a little fan action because it is boiling hot in here. Stop this video right now and get some water, stay hydrated. I have never seen Taylor live in concert before because the time where I became like a really big fan was a time where she was not really going on tour anymore. So I, growing up, obviously heard Taylor's music like most people. My younger sister Bella, who I went with, this is why she went, was kind of a nostalgia thing, was a huge fan of Taylor during like the Fearless, Speak Now, Red era. And me, you know, being a child, being a sibling, didn't want to like anything that my younger sister liked, so I just didn't even show any interest towards Taylor. I was very much, you know, at that age into like Nelly Furtado, the Pussycat Dolls, and then growing up was like Halsey and Melanie Martinez and Panic at the Disco. But when Reputation came out, I just remember being so interested in that sound and being like, wow, this is so different from anything that Taylor has done before. This is, I can really vibe with this. And this is when I started listening to Taylor more, so that would have been 2017. And then I went back, listened to the older stuff, always had a really strong connection with Red. Then Lover came out and there were a couple songs on there that really just were a vibe. And then I was just started going through her discography, doing it in a very chill way. I wasn't really online with anyone, connecting in that way. It was like a very personal thing. Then I became friends with these two creators who are like big Swifty creators. And I became more of a Swifty through them. This was in like 2020. I started dating someone who was a Swifty. So by the time she started doing the re-recordings, it was just really delving me deeper into Taylor's old music and just falling in love with it. And then I was there while she was announcing Folklore and Evermore. That was a crazy year. And then obviously we had Midnights, and I've just been getting deeper and deeper into the thick of it. So I haven't been to a Taylor concert before, because when I became like a proper fan where I would do that, she wasn't doing concerts anymore. So growing up as a teenager, I just didn't go to concerts in general. And prior to this, the only concerts I have been to was Billie Eilish's When We All Fall Asleep, Where Do We Go tour, which was like
at a venue, but it wasn't a stadium. And then Conan Gray's Super Egg Tour, I think it was called, which was in an arena. So this was on a whole nother level. And I was definitely nervous about the crowd because I was going to Taylor's biggest concert ever, 96,000 people. But I actually wasn't bothered by the crowd at all. I was just overcome with excitement and joy and disbelief. And it's so crazy to me how I got these tickets in June of 2023, which was an absolute nightmare. I'm so jealous and happy for those who got multiple tickets. I don't know how you did it. I struggled just to get one. That by the time I rolled around, I just couldn't believe that it was here. I had waited over half a year for this concert and I was there. And like, if we're gonna start from the beginning, like the whole outfit journey, it's fun coming up with an outfit, but oh my God, that was stressful, like trying to organize it all. And then friendship bracelets, I tried to make as many as I could, but I dropped my beads everywhere. So there's like a lot of prep before the concert and then trying to get a hotel room and like flights during this inflation period because so many people were flying to Melbourne because Taylor only did concerts in two cities of the whole of Australia and there's people coming from other countries. So it's very expensive and difficult, but for me, I just really didn't care. Like I was like, I'm gonna do anything I have to do to be at this concert. Memories are more important than money. You know, obviously don't be too financially irresponsible. I was a little bit, I'm not gonna lie. When we got there, we went straight into the stadium and we were there a couple minutes, probably 10, 15 minutes before Sabrina came on. So we got a drink and I'm a little bit sad. I spoke about this in my vlog, but I was really looking forward to seeing Sabrina. I actually started listening to her music once Taylor announced that she was gonna be an opener for the tour. And I really enjoy her music. And this has nothing to do with the concert, Sabrina, anything like that. It just so happened that where we were sitting, which was in the lower bowl center on, the sun had started setting and it was blaring in our eyes and it was extremely hot. Like I was struggling with the sun beaming down on us and I could really barely see Sabrina. So I was trying to like see her, and then there were times where we would like go undercover to try and see her a bit better. So I was a little sad that I didn't get to see more of her, but it was still nice to be able to like hear some of her songs. That, you know, kind of feels like two concerts in one. And then once Taylor came on, I obviously filmed my reaction, which was nuts. Like throughout this whole concert, I did not feel my body. Like I was just in my mind. Like I could not feel when I needed to go to the bathroom, when I like was tired or sore. I felt nothing. I was just so in my mind, captivated by what was going on. I just remember it not feeling real. Like once Taylor came on stage, like my brain just wasn't comprehending that that was her. Maybe it's because she was kind of far away, even though we were in the lower bowl, because the MCG is so big. Like I said, the stage doesn't even take up half of the floor. So it was kind of hard to see her without looking at the screen, but it was just amazing. The atmosphere, the vibe. We were in a pretty good section. The people there were pretty nice. There were a couple judgy people when we were a little bit too intense. My sister was sitting next to someone who like was watching the entire concert through her camera and kept like elbowing her and pushing her. So I'm coming for you. I'm kidding. And yeah, I don't know. The lover section, I didn't film that much, which I'm kind of sad. Like my brain doesn't even remember watching like You Need to Calm Down or The Man, which pisses me off because I love The Man, and You Need to Calm Down is like a fun song in the stadium. So I don't know why, like if I didn't record it, my brain just doesn't remember. Concert amnesia is a real fucking thing, I swear to God. Then we got to the Fearless set. Love Fearless, wish it was longer, but you know, can't fault it. And then we had Evermore. I barely filmed anything. I was just so in it. I have, even though Red is like my favorite album, I have such a special place for Evermore. I just feel like such a deep connection to a lot of the songs on there. And when I was listening to Tolerated, I just felt a overwhelming spiritual feeling. That is one of my top five Taylor Swift songs. And it's just like amazing to see it live happening in front of you. And the Champagne Problem standing ovation was just amazing. My ears were ringing from how loud everyone was cheering. And it was just such a unifying experience to see people singing these songs that you enjoy. A lot of people didn't know all of the songs, but you know, that's okay. Everybody's on their own journey. We were in a pretty good section. I saw some videos of some people where people were straight up sitting through the whole of Folklore and Evermore. So that's a crime. I mean, if you need to sit because you're in pain, that's fine. But sitting through a whole set is kind of sus. And then what was after Evermore? Oh my God, how could I forget? Going into Reputation. I would definitely say that Reputation was my favorite set of the concert. It was so much fun. And I've always wished I could go back in time and go to the Reputation Stadium tour. I watched the film all the time. And it was so incredibly fun and just such a spectacle. And the stage presence that Taylor has and her backup dancers, all the different things, the lights, I can't even describe it. It's like a experience I've never felt before. And it was just spiritual. Like when she was doing that long note from Don't Blame Me, like I just remember, I think I was in the vlog, I was just looking up and I was like having an out of body experience. And then from Reputation, we go into Speak Now, which was beautiful, stunning. Enchanted was amazing. Long Live was triumphant.
After Speak Now, we go into Red, I think, if I'm remembering correctly. Or do we go into Folklore? I can't remember if it's Red or Folklore. I feel like it's Red. So yeah, we go into Red, and Red is my favorite album, like I've said, but Taylor only performs the singles, which are fun, but I was like really sad about like not having any deep cuts, but it was still a ton of fun. I will say that the three songs kind of felt like they blurred together. I don't know why. I don't know if I was just delirious. To the point that when she finished the last of the singles, I was like, oh, Red's over. And then I don't know why my brain completely forgot that All Too Well 10-minute version was coming next. And that was just like, I don't remember it. I was just in it. I was feeling it. And I just kept like pointing to Taylor, and when she would wave, I'd wave back. I was like pretending like there was no one there except me and her. Center of the universe brain. What can I say? And then after Red, I'm pretty sure it's Folklore. Yeah, Folklore. And Folklore was stunning. The way Taylor was billing around, we got the green dress, which I was so happy about because that's my favorite Folklore dress. And Folklore was just such an amazing experience. The interlude from Illicit Affairs, I just, August, Betty. I don't know why my brain doesn't remember Great American Dynasty at all. That's what really bothers me about this concert amnesia thing, is like, I don't remember anything I didn't film. But then I didn't want to film too much because I wanted to be in the moment. It's really a double-edged sword. And then after that, we had 1989, which was probably my, I don't know, I loved Reputation because it was so slay. I loved Folklore because it was beautiful. I would say maybe third is 1989 because 1989 was just banger after banger. It was a bit longer of a set and it was so much fun. Bad Blood with the fire. Oh, Blank Space. I was trying to like yell out Sydney, but then no one was doing it. People were yelling out Melbourne. It's kind of funny. From the 1989 film tour. And then after that, we went into surprise songs. Oh, I'm gonna need to take a breather real quick. When it came to surprise songs, I had a list on my phone of like what surprise song I would love. And at the top of my list was I Almost Do, which is my favorite Taylor Swift song. I also have other Red songs in there, like Treacherous and stuff. Either way, I just would have loved to have a Red deep cut song. And by deep cut, I mean a song that wasn't a single, a song that's not on the set. So when Taylor came out and she was in the yellow dress, and you know if she's in the yellow dress, what's about to happen. She only does fucked up things in that yellow dress. And she said she was about to play one of her favorite songs. And I was like, oh my God, what could this be? I was like, is this gonna be a Folklore song? We know how much she loves Folklore. And then she starts playing Red. And you saw my reaction. I freaked the fuck out. I could not believe it. Like, I think I said this in the vlog. There were obviously other people wearing red outfits for sure. My brain just didn't see any. I'm sure there were other people wearing red outfits, but it was definitely one of the underrepresented eras in terms of what people were wearing. I'd say the most popular was like Lover for sure. Even when I was trading friendship bracelets, everyone wanted Lover friendship bracelets and I didn't have any. There was Lover, Fearless for sure, Reputation, Midnight. I would say those are the most popular eras, but I was already losing it. And then I really started to lose it when she started sitting down at the piano giving like a speech, like, because normally she would, for her announcement, she would give speeches before both surprise songs while she's on the guitar. And then she starts talking, and she starts talking about the Tortured Poets Department, her new album. I think she might have spoken about it during her Champagne Problems speech. I don't know. But she was also showing a lot of love to the Melbourne crowd. Like, she really was just amazed and was appreciating how supportive we were. The standing ovation during Champagne Problems, she took her ear pieces out and was just like absorbing the crowd. And at this point, she's talking about how much releasing this new album means to her and how she felt like she had to do it. And it really, the way she was talking about it, felt like the way she spoke about Red. And I was like, oh my God, it's gonna be a Red 2.0. I'm not ready. I'm not ready. I already have so much anticipation for this album, like no other. Like, don't get me wrong, I was excited for Midnights, but I did not feel like this kind of way about it as I do for the Tortured Poets Department, because I'm just like, I have this feeling it's gonna be similar to Red, and I need that in my life. I need like soul-crushing emotional wreckage, because that's what I need, and I'm excited. So when she was talking about that, she was really like, at this point, the way she was talking about it, we all thought she was gonna play a song from the new album. I don't know why I thought that, because looking back, that's crazy, but just the way she was talking about it. And then she shows the new cover, which is, what is it? Is it the Bolter? Yeah, the Bolter cover. So that was the first variant announcement with the bonus track. I don't think I did it in the concert. I think maybe as soon as we got to the hotel room, I ordered it. So that was good. Luckily, the way when she's announcing it, like, and putting it live on the website, most of the country is asleep. So, I mean, the world. So Australia wins in that regard. And then, yeah, after that, she was like, okay, I'm going to play a song. And I was like, okay, what song is this going to be? I need to hear it. And then she starts playing the instrumental on the piano. And I'm like trying to catch what it is. And then she starts singing You're Losing Me. I lose it over You're Losing Me, because I love You're Losing Me. It's that song that she released like was it a year after Midnight? Maybe 6 months after Midnight, but then the only way you could get it was in a physical CD at the show, and then she released it on streaming on her birthday last year, which was over a year after Midnight came out. It's like a, and it's like a vault for Midnight because it was actually written in 2021. It's a very special song. It's a very deeply emotional song. She has her own heartbeat in the backing track. I think that's why I didn't recognize it as soon as she started playing it on the piano, because of the missing heartbeat. And I just feel like no one expected her to play this song because it's so deeply crushing and emotional. But I think it makes sense for her to play this song because this song seems like the bridge between Midnight and the Tortured Poets Department. It seems like it's going to be more about the themes that are on the new album, so it made sense that she played it, and I was just genuinely not okay. So after the surprise songs, I really needed a breather. I was just overwhelmed beyond belief, and then when like the Midnight intro started, that's when I realized, oh shit, this is the last set of the concert. And I was like, okay, you need to take this all in. So I really just told myself to get out of my head and just really absorb what I was watching. That's why I started filming a little bit more of the Midnight section, and I was just trying to soak it all in, because by the time we got to Karma, I was not okay. Like, I was so sad. Like, I was happy because it was amazing, but I was sad that it was over. And I was also surprised that I was not in pain or tired at all, because I was just standing for like 4 hours straight, basically. And it was a mission to get home. It was a nightmare. I mean, trying to get 96,000 people out of there. All the trams just kept being full. Ubers would cancel. It was a mess, but I digress. And then for the rest of the trip, and even since I got back, I've just been trying to get a ticket to another show. While I was in Melbourne, I was trying to see if I could get a ticket to another show in Melbourne. When we left Melbourne, I was really sad because I was like, oh, I guess that's not going to happen. And then when I got home, I was like, stuff it. I'll just like try to get a ticket to the Sydney show. I mean, it's a 10-hour drive from where I live, but I'll drive, I'll take breaks, I'll stay in a hostel, I'll camp in a tent, I don't care. I wanted to go back so bad because of this whole concert amnesia thing. Like, I'm just really upset, and people keep asking me like, oh, were you too drunk? I'm like, no, I had like a couple drinks over the span of like 6 hours, like from when I was getting ready to like halfway through the concert. I really was not drunk. I think it was just an immense amount of shock because I was anticipating this for so long. I obsessed to a healthy degree about Taylor, and I love her and her music, and it's just such a big part of my life. And I need to do some more studying about it, but I've been in a really big post-concert depression. It actually took me a couple days before I even wanted to like look at my footage for this vlog because I was worried it'd make me feel too sad. But editing it actually made me really happy once I had accepted I wasn't going to go to any more of her shows, because I was trying for the last minute release tickets for the marketplace. I genuinely don't understand how people get multiple tickets to the shows. I don't get it. It's too late, but I wish I knew how, because I tried every day and I couldn't get another one. But at the end of the day, there's some people who couldn't get any at all. So you're seeing both sides of the spectrum. I'm just grateful that I got to go at least once. It was truly a once in a lifetime experience. I'll obviously go to Taylor's next tour, whatever it is, but I think it'll be a very long time before she has a tour this monumentous, where she's singing songs from all of her eras. Well, not all, because we didn't get a debut song, which, I mean, we're all salty about that, aren't we? Could have given us just one song. Our song. How about that? But no, it was amazing. It was truly a beautiful experience. And was it financially responsible? Well, yes, but memories are more important than money. And I will pick myself back up on my bootstraps. Now that Christmas, New Year's, my birthday, my sister's birthday, like the ERAS tour of Melbourne is all over, I have nothing really big coming up. So I'm just focused on staying at home, making content, and, you know, being productive. And yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say. I hope I said everything I wanted to say. I feel like my brain is still mush. It's been really difficult, honestly. I think I'll feel better once the Australian leg of the tour is over, because then it'll feel too far away to feel sad about, because right now, like, Sydney's not that far from me and the shows are happening there, so it's making me sad. But happy for anyone who got to go. If you did go, let me know what your surprise songs were. Let me know what your favorite set of the show was. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this vlog. I hope to pop over here on this channel again sometime soon. I think I'll just post vlogs on here when I feel like it, when something interesting's happening. And then obviously always posting on my main channel. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. I hope you have a beautiful day or night wherever you're in the world. And that's it from me to you. Lots of love. Bye.